I once went with Don Henley to Washington, D.C. a few years ago. And amongst talking to Senator McCain and about 8 or 10 other United States senators, all of the FCC commissioners, the last meeting we found ourselves in was with the chairman of the FCC, myself and Don Henley in a room. What the hell? This guy could squash my career like that. And at that time, it was Michael Powell, the son of Colin Powell. And I got into this with him. And I said, Mr. Powell, Chairman Powell, please, you're the head of the FCC. This deregulation is killing my industry. It's killing what Don's doing. And he said, oh, no. We're not doing that. And I said, well, why don't you do something about it? He goes, we're a regulatory body, Jim. You know, Congress passes the law. Not only, and I know he knows what I was saying. I know he knew what I was saying. He didn't care. Congress made a law. He's going to enforce that law. And that's how they got around it, is because the heads of the communications industry went and they said, look, remove that 7 and 7 thing. We want to own everything. So his argument was, well, the government didn't pass a law saying, you know, you can't play whatever you want on the radio. The government didn't say that you have to have a restricted playlist. No, all they did was make it possible for somebody to do that because somebody paid them off, okay? Now, having said that, guess who was as Don Henley and I sat in the waiting room of the chairman of the FCC's office to go in and talk about the First Amendment, guess who we were waiting on for the meeting to get over with and walked out right before us, as we're sitting in the lobby? Rupert Murdoch and his contingent. Now, do you think that Rupert Murdoch probably got a more favorable response than I did? You're damn straight.